Good morning. So welcome to another class of yes, General Science. Thank you. It's a revision class, and the last class we discussed about our lesson number 4, what force and energy. And today we are going to revise our questions and lesson number 1, weather, sun, air, and water. Okay, lesson 1. So in this chapter, we already discussed about weather, air, land breeze, sea breeze, then water, precipitation, impurities of water, purification of water, and underground water. So we just rewind the portions. So weather is the day-to-day condition of atmosphere at a given place at a given time. And all changes in weather caused primarily due to the sun. Then we discussed about air. What do you mean by air? Air is a mixture of gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, argon, etc. Then about sea breeze and land breeze. So what is the difference between sea breeze and land breeze? What do you mean by sea breeze? Sea breeze means the wind blowing from sea to land is called a sea breeze, and the wind blowing from land to sea is called a land breeze. The wind blows from sea to land is sea breeze, and the wind blows from land to sea is land breeze. Okay, then we studied about evaporation. We just rewind the important things from the first lesson. Then the first one is evaporation, different states of water. Which are the different states of water? There are 3 states of water, and they are solid, liquid, and gaseous. Okay, and solid that is ice, liquid that is water, and gas that is water vapor. Then we discussed about evaporation, condensation, precipitation, and also about humidity, water cycle, sedimentation, decantation, filtration, chlorination. So we just rewind the important portion from our first lesson, weather, sun, air, and water. And the first thing is evaporation. Evaporation. So what do you mean by evaporation? It's a process. Evaporation is the natural process by which water changes to water vapor on heating. When the water changes to water vapor on heating is called the evaporation. Water changes to water vapor on heating. Is called evaporation. 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 So evaporation is a process which water changes to water vapor on heating. When the water changes to water vapor on heating is called evaporation. Then condensation. Water or cooling is called condensation. Condensation is a process when at least water vapor changes to water on cooling. And the water changes to water vapor on heating is called evaporation. And the water vapor changes to water on cooling is called condensation. Then we discussed about sea breeze and land breeze. Difference between sea breeze and land breeze. Sea breeze. The wind blowing from sea to land. The wind blowing from sea to land is called the sea breeze. And what do you mean by land breeze? The wind blowing from land to sea is called a land breeze. The wind blowing from land to sea is called a land breeze. So evaporation means the process by which water changes to water vapor on heating is called evaporation, and the process which water vapor changes to water on cooling is called condensation. Then sea breeze. Sea breeze means the wind blowing from sea to land is called a sea breeze, and the wind blowing from land to sea is called a land breeze. Okay. Then we discussed about humidity. What is humidity? The amount of moisture present in the air is called a humidity. The amount of moisture present in the air is called a humidity. So once again, evaporation. Evaporation is a process by which water changes to water vapor on heating, and condensation is a process by which water vapor changes to water on cooling. Then the difference between sea breeze and land breeze. Sea breeze is the wind blowing from sea to land, and land breeze means the wind blowing from land to sea. And what is the difference between breeze and wind? The gentle moving air is called a breeze, and the fast moving air is called a breeze. Then the next one is humidity.
Before that, water cycle. What do you mean by water cycle?
The cycle of water through evaporation, condensation and precipitation is called the water cycle. Then precipitation, what do you mean by precipitation? The falling of water in any form on the earth is called the precipitation. The falling of water in any form on the earth is called precipitation. So which are the different forms of precipitation? The different forms of precipitation are hail, dew, frost, snow and fog. Hail, snow, dew, frost and fog are the different forms of precipitation. Then impurities of water. So impurities of water means the unwanted substance present in water is called impurities, and we can remove the impurities from water in two ways. That is, we can remove soluble impurities by boiling, and insoluble impurities can be removed by sedimentation, decantation, filtration, adding chlorine tablets, that means chlorination, etc. Okay, so precipitation means the falling of water in any form on the earth is called precipitation. Then which are the processes that we used to remove the impurities present in water? So there are two types of impurities present in water: soluble impurities and insoluble impurities. And the soluble impurities are removed by boiling, and insoluble impurities present in water can be removed by sedimentation, decantation, filtration, adding chlorine tablets, that is chlorination. So let's see what are the difference between sedimentation, decantation, chlorination and filtration, and the different methods that we use to remove the insoluble impurities present in water are filtration, sedimentation, decantation, chlorination. So the first one is filtration. So what do you mean by filtration? Passing of water through filters on removed impurities are called filtration. Passing of water through filters to remove impurities are called filtration. Passing of water through filters on removing impurities are called filtration. Then sedimentation. S-E-D-I-M-E-N-T-A-T-I-O-N, sedimentation. So what do you mean by sedimentation? A process in which water is allowed to stand for a couple of minutes or couple of hours. Then the heavier impurities settle at the bottom of the container. Then we can separate the clean water from that. So it is called sedimentation. Then the third process is decantation. Decantation. So what do you mean by decantation? A water purification process. It's a water purification process, and in this water is slowly poured off into another container after sedimentation. So water is poured off into another container after sedimentation, and the process is called decantation. Then the next process is chlorination. C-H-L-O-R-I-N-A-T-I-O-N, chlorination. So what do you mean by chlorination? The process of purification of water in which chlorine tablets are added to kill the germs present in water and is called chlorination. So chlorine tablets is a chemical that is added to water to kill germs. So the insoluble impurities present in water can be removed by these four methods, that are filtration, sedimentation, decantation and chlorination. And the soluble impurities can be removed by boiling. So these are the important things that we discussed in our lesson 1, that is weather, sun, air and water. about weather, so all weather changes brought about mainly by the sun, and the heat of the sun causes difference in air pressure due to the which air blows from one place to another. And we also studied about evaporation. So what do you mean by evaporation? The process by which water changes to water vapor on heating is called evaporation, and the process by which water vapor changes into water on cooling is called condensation. Then sea breeze means the wind blowing from sea to land is called sea breeze, and the wind blowing from land to sea is called land breeze. Then we studied about impurities present in water. Unwanted substances present in water is called impurities, and the impurities are of two types: soluble impurities and insoluble impurities. And the soluble impurities can be removed by boiling, and the insoluble impurities present in water can be removed by sedimentation, decantation, filtration, and chlorination. Chlorination means adding chlorine tablets to water to kill germs, and the process is called chlorination. So now we just move to our exercise portion. Just rewrite the exercise portion given in your textbook, page number 133. And here the first section is tick the correct answer. And the first question: changes in the weather are caused primarily due to sun. Changes in weather are caused primarily due to sun. Water should be boiled for at least 10 minutes to kill germs. Water should be boiled for at least 15 to 20 minutes to kill germs. Then the change of water into water vapor on heating is called evaporation. The change of water into water vapor on heating is called evaporation. And the storm is caused due to wind, and the land and sea breezes are caused due to land is heated and cooled faster than water. Then the next one is fill in the blanks. First question: the dark causes all changes in weather. So the sun causes all changes in weather. So the primary reason of changes in weather are caused primarily due to the sun. So the sun causes all changes in weather. Then hot air is lighter and rises. Then land breeze blows during the night. Then the land gets heated faster than water. The rate of evaporation increases with temperature. And ash is a chemical added to water to kill germs. Chlorine tablets are chemicals that are added to water to kill germs. Then the next section is write down C4 condensation or E4 evaporation in the following. And the first statement: water drops collect outside the cold bottle kept on a table. So water drops collect outside the cold bottle. It's condensation. This means the water vapor present in the air converts into water on cooling. So condensation. Second question: you can see your breath when you blow from your mouth on every very cold day. So you can see breathe when you blow from your mouth on a very cold day. It's evaporation. Then your sweat. And the first one is condensation. Second one is evaporation. Then the third one is your sweat disappears when you stand under a fan. Then our sweat disappears and it's evaporation. The sweats are in the form of water droplets. It disappears in the form of water vapor. So water changes into water vapor. It's evaporation. Then drops of water are seen on grass on a cold winter morning. It's condensation. The water vapor present in the atmosphere changes to water droplets in the cold morning. So it's condensation. Then true or false. First question: the sea breeze blows during the day. Is it true or false? It's true. Sea breeze blows during the day. Then the second question: filtration mainly removes soluble impurities present in water. It's false. Filtration removes insoluble impurities present in water. The soluble impurities can be removed by boiling. Then the third question, water cools down faster than land. It's true. During the daytime, water cools faster than land. Then the fourth question, evaporation is faster on a humid day. Humidity means the amount of moisture present in the air. On a humid day, the rate of evaporation is slow. Then the fifth question, on heating, liquid water cannot change to water vapor. It's false. On heating, liquid water can change to water vapor. When we heat water, it changes to water vapor. So the given statement is false. Then answer the following questions. And first one, distinguish between evaporation and condensation. So evaporation and condensation means the water, the process by which water changes to water vapor on heating is called evaporation, and the process by which water vapor changes to water on cooling is called condensation. Then explain how clouds are formed. The clouds are formed by the process of condensation. Then what are the different forms of precipitation? Which are the different forms of precipitation? The different forms of precipitation are hails, fog, smoke, dew, etc. Then why are coastal regions present during daytime? During daytime, sea breeze of course. So the coastal regions present during daytime. Then name the different process used in removing soluble impurities. So the soluble impurities can be removed by boiling, and the insoluble impurities can be removed by sedimentation, decantation, filtration and chlorination. So these are the things all about our lesson 1, weather, sun, air and water. And we just move to our next lesson. To remind our next lesson, that is green earth. So lesson 2, green earth. So green earth, in this chapter we discussed about our planet earth. So the only planet with life is earth, and the major part of earth is covered with water, and the gas that all living beings require to live is oxygen. Then in this chapter we discussed about environment and about pollution. Then how to minimize and control pollution. Then about 3 R's, reduce, reuse and recycle. Okay, so what do you mean by environment? The surrounding area including air, water, land, plants, animals and humans are called environment. So environment is our surrounding area. Then pollution. What is pollution? Addition of harmful substances in the environment is called pollution. And there are different types of pollution like soil pollution, water pollution, air pollution, etc. Then what is soil erosion? The loss of the topmost layer of the soil is called as soil erosion. The loss of the topmost layer of the soil is called as soil erosion. Then we discussed about difference between deforestation and afforestation. What is deforestation? Deforestation and afforestation. So deforestation means the cutting down of a large number of trees from an area is called deforestation, and afforestation means the planting of large number of trees in a barren area is called afforestation. Deforestation is the cutting down of plants. Afforestation is the planting of trees. So the cutting down of a large number of plants in an area is called deforestation, and the planting of large number of an area is called a afforestation. Then we discussed about biodegradable and non-biodegradable wastes. So what do you mean by biodegradable wastes? Wastes that decomposes easily and mixes with soil is called biodegradable wastes. And non-biodegradable waste means waste that does not decompose easily and remains in the soil or in the environment for a long time is called non-biodegradable wastes. Okay. So what is the difference between deforestation and afforestation? Deforestation is the cutting down of plants from an area and cutting down of large number of trees from an area is called deforestation, and the planting of large number of plants in an area is called afforestation. So these are the things that we discussed in our lesson 2, and we also discussed about things that we get from environment. So we get many things from environment, like to fulfill our needs, like we get oxygen for breathing, and also we get clothes and food items and everything from our environment. So it's our responsibility to keep our environment neat and clean. Then deforestation is threat to our environment, it's very harmful to our environment. So it's a bad habit, and we always plant a large number of trees, not cut down trees. Then we discussed about pollution. So what do you mean by pollution? Pollution is the addition of harmful substances to the environment is called pollution. So we are just going to revise our exercise portion in lesson 2. And the first one, tick the correct answer. First question, burning of coal causes. That's burning of coal causes air pollution. Environment includes, now environment is the surrounding area, and it includes both living and non-living things. So environment includes water, air, land and living things. So the answer is both of these. Then third question, motor vehicles and aircraft mainly cause air pollution and noise pollution. Then sometimes dirt, sewage and industrial waste mix in water and make the water polluted. Then fill in the blanks. Loud sound creates noise pollution. Then an increase in atmospheric carbon dioxide may lead to global warming. The increase in carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is called global warming. Dash pollution is caused by some biodegradable and mostly by non-biodegradable wastes. So soil pollution is caused by some biodegradable and mostly by non-biodegradable wastes. Then industrial wastes usually cause water pollution. Industrial wastes, the wastes from industries usually cause water pollution. Then match the following question. Air pollution. So air pollution is caused by smoke from industries and vehicles. Air pollution is caused by smoke from industries and vehicles. Then land pollution. Land pollution is caused by non-biodegradable wastes. Water pollution, industrial liquid waste. Then noise pollution, be caused by bursting of crackers. So air pollution, smoke from industries and vehicles. Land pollution, non-biodegradable wastes. Water pollution, industrial liquid waste. Noise pollution, bursting of crackers. Then write true or false. First question, cutting plants does not affect the environment. Is it true or false? It's false. Cutting plants affect the environment. The air pollution can be caused by gaseous pollution. Yes, the smoke is a form of gas, and the gaseous forms spread to air, then it causes air pollution. So the statement is true. Avoid excess use of pesticides. It's true. Avoid excess use of pesticides. Then always use plastic bag. Is it true or false? It's false. Plastic is a non-biodegradable product. So avoid the use of plastic. So reduce the use of plastic. Always throw the garbage in the open. Is it true or false? No. It farts always throw the garbage in the do not throw the garbage in the mop and the statement is false. Then answer the following question. Define pollution. Pollution is the addition of harmful substances in the environment. So addition of harmful substances in the environment is called pollution. Then how can we control soil pollution? How can we control soil pollution? We can control soil pollution by do not throw garbage in the open and also avoid the use of plastic, and like that we can control the or minimize soil pollution. Then write three major causes of water pollution. The water pollution mainly causes wastes from industries and also the liquid wastes like that are household wastes. Then what is deforestation? What are deforestation? The cutting down of plants. Cutting down of large number of plants in an area is called deforestation. So these are the things all about that we discuss in our lesson 2. So our lesson 1 is sun, weather, sun, air and water. In that chapter we discussed about weather, then weather and the sun, then about air, sea breeze, land breeze, and about water, three states of water, evaporation and the factors that influence the rate of evaporation, and water cycle, then the different forms of precipitation, then impurities of water. There are two types of impurities, soluble and insoluble impurities, and soluble impurities can be removed by boiling and insoluble impurities can be removed by sedimentation, decantation, filtration and adding chlorine tablets. Then we discussed about lesson 2, green earth, about environment and the things that we get from environment, and about pollution, air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, and minimizing and controlling air pollution, and also about the exercise portion. So these are all about our lesson number 1 and 2 and so revision class. So you just read your text one and more times, and the text reading is very very important, and if you have any doubts ask me, okay. So today let's write the class, and we will meet with another class on next day, and in that class we discussed about revenge our next 2 chapters. So now let's write the class. Okay students, study well, have a nice day. Thank you.